Hello, I'm Deputy Chase Armington with the Queen Anne's County Sheriff's Office at the Queen Anne's County Public Television Station Channel 7 with your traffic safety monthly update for the month of May.
Hi, I'm Sheriff Gary Hoffman, and I want to welcome all our viewers.
Sheriff, the month of May has been very busy for Queen Anne's County Sheriff's Office and traffic safety. Three of the initiatives that we focused on this month were motorcycle safety, seatbelt, the clicker ticket national campaign, and older driver awareness. The motorcycle safety, we focused on to let the public know to be aware and look twice to save a life. The Click It or Ticket campaign is a national campaign that we participate in through grant money that does not cost taxpayers anything extra through what we provide in our service. We focus on drivers not wearing their seatbelts, and the current laws in Maryland are anybody in the front seats that are next to a door need to be seatbelted. Additionally, anybody that's under the age of 16, regardless of where they sit in the vehicle, needs to be seatbelted. And then the other laws that apply to children under 8 and a certain age and a certain weight that need to be in a booster seat or a car seat. Finally, the last thing that we focused on was the awareness of older drivers. And it's not that we're picking on older drivers or looking for anybody that shouldn't be driving. What it is just the awareness that there's things that the MVA offers, such as emergency contact cards, that you can print out yourself and fill out and place in your vehicle or your parents' vehicle or your grandparents' vehicle. And the reason that we focus on older drivers is that when they're involved in crashes, they don't have the same healing ability that younger people do. So we need to make sure that the safety is on the roads for them as well.
One of the things that we see too often is that someone just doesn't take the time to make that seatbelt click. You know, it takes 3 seconds to put that seatbelt on. We see people all the time that are ejected from vehicles, fatal crashes and things, and so many times we just wonder, why didn't they just take that time to put that seatbelt on? It would have saved their lives.
You're right. Statistics show that seatbelts save lives, and it's just that 3 seconds.
The number one complaint that I get as sheriff, and the number one complaint that I'm sure you all get on the street, is speeding in and around our residential neighborhoods. This is one area where we've got to take the time as a community to remind our visitors, our family and friends, that they need to slow down when they're entering these neighborhoods. It's one of those things where we're doing the education, we're doing the awareness, but we're going to be doing much more aggressive enforcement. We've got to get a message out there to our community that they've got to slow down in these neighborhoods. You know, lives are at jeopardy, people are walking on the streets, people have animals that are out there. There's things like that that are out there that are being taken by speeders. So we need to make this message very clear that the Office of the Sheriff is going to be doing aggressive speed enforcement in the neighborhoods to help assist this problem and hopefully save some lives. Now, I know that you're involved in traffic safety and doing a lot with that. Some statistical information you can provide to the public?
Well, with each increase in mile per hour, there's an increase in mechanism of injury in a crash. Whereas the faster you're going, the more potential for injury there is. Now, with vehicle safety standards and everything being updated, those injuries are decreasing, but there's still a direct relation to speed and injury. It's like your video says, speed kills.
And one of the things now, we're not only dealing with speeding vehicles, but we're dealing with people that are riding down the road, they're text messaging, they're using cell phones, and they're distracted, and combining distractive driving with speeding, it's a recipe for disaster.
It sure is.
So the message to the community is slow down. Let your visitors know, let your family members know that you've got to slow down in these neighborhoods. You know, I mean, we don't want to be the ones out there writing the enforcement paperwork, but we're going to have to do that to get the community to slow down.
Well, it's as simple as let your action prevent our reaction.
Very good point. So hopefully all the people in the neighborhood that we see will be doing the speed limit. Our crashes will be down, our speeding complaints will be down, and our seniors, our kids, and our animals will be much safer. Your efforts in traffic safety are very much appreciated. I know the community appreciates them as well as our office does as well. Thanks for taking the time to come in.
Well, thank you, sir, for allowing me to do this, and I couldn't do it without the support of you and our deputies.